Everything is different now.
But do not get tired of doing what is good.
At just the right time, you will reap a harvest if you don't give up.
You can rejoice when you run into these problems and trials, for they are helping you develop endurance.
And endurance develops strength of character.
And character strengthens our confident hope in salvation.
A hope that will not lead to disappointment.
Think of how dearly God loves you, for he has given you his Holy Spirit to fill your hearts with his love.
Such love has no fear.
Because perfect love expels all fear.
So don't worry about anything.
Instead, pray about everything.
Tell God what you need.
And thank him for all that he has done.
Then you will experience God's peace,
which exceeds anything we can understand.
Do not be afraid. God is with you.
Don't be discouraged, for the Lord is your God.
He will strengthen you and help you.
He will hold you up with his victorious right hand.
So in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit,
guard yourselves
and guard God's people.
Feed and shepherd God's flock,
his church,
purchased with his own blood,
over which the Holy Spirit has anointed you as leaders.
For you are among the gifts that God gave to the church.
The apostles,
the prophets,
the evangelists,
and the pastors and teachers.
Your responsibility is to equip God's people to do his work.
And to build up the church.
The body of Christ.
Preach the word of God.
Be prepared.
Whether the time is favorable or not.
Patiently correct, rebuke, and encourage God's people with your teaching.
For you speak as a messenger approved by God.
To be entrusted with the good news.
Rejoice in your confident hope.
Be patient in trouble.
And keep on praying.
And now may the God of all hope
fill you with all joy and peace
as you trust in him,
so you may overflow with hope
through the power of the Holy Spirit.